Here we're going to take a look at the enthalpy of solution of potassium chloride, formula KCl. Again, remember that these energy cycles typically have three interconnecting steps. We can consider the salt, potassium chloride, dissolving in water to form a solution in which potassium and chloride ions are hydrated. That's known as enthalpy of solution. We could find the enthalpy of solution by the sum of two alternative steps. We could consider taking solid potassium chloride and supplying enough energy to dissociate the lattice to produce gaseous potassium ions and gaseous chloride ions. And then taking those gaseous potassium and chloride ions, adding them to water to carry out what's called hydration. And we have the enthalpy of hydration of the ions. So the enthalpy of solution down here at the bottom of potassium chloride could be found as the sum of two steps, namely the lattice enthalpy of dissociation plus the enthalpy of hydration of the potassium ion plus the plus the enthalpy of hydration of the chloride ion, represented by this equation here. This symbol stands for sum of. So the enthalpy solution is the lattice enthalpy of dissociation, this step here, plus the sum of the enthalpies of hydrations of the cation, which in this case is potassium, and the anion, which in this case is chloride. Let's look at this again in a little bit more detail. This represents the KCl as a solid, where we have potassium and chloride ions held in what is known as a lattice structure, each positive ion surrounded by several ions of the opposite charge and vice versa. Lattice enthalpy of dissociation considers supplying the energy to break that lattice apart and produce gaseous potassium ions and gaseous chloride ions. And then we can consider adding those ions to water. If we add a mole of potassium and a mole of chloride ions to water, then we get this taking place. We get the enthalpy of hydration of the potassium ions and the enthalpy of hydration of the chloride ions, producing these ion clusters. This particular step, it will be exothermic. We're producing lots of attractions between the ions and the water dipoles. So the enthalpy of solution here at the bottom is the sum of these two steps. Enthalpy of solution is the lattice enthalpy of dissociation plus the enthalpy of hydration of the potassium ions plus the enthalpy of hydration of the chloride ions. Okay, pause the slide here, please. Take down the information and draw out your energy cycle as shown and estimate the enthalpy of solvation or enthalpy of solution of potassium chloride, please. Okay, you might want to pause this and consider putting the various values in. Remember, aqueous allows us to avoid defining the number of water molecules required to hydrate both the potassium and the chloride ions in solution. So we just write plus AQ, a non-defined number of water molecules. Okay, so we're going to take the solid potassium chloride and create gaseous potassium ions and gaseous chloride ions. That is the lattice enthalpy of dissociation, and that figure has been given to us as plus 715. If we're given the lattice enthalpy of formation, that will be will have a negative value. It'll be exothermic. Lattice enthalpy of dissociation will always be endothermic, requiring energy, so plus 715. We've been given the enthalpy of hydration of the cation, the positive ion, as minus 322. This will always be negative, minus 322. And the enthalpy of hydration of the anion, in this case chloride, as being minus 313. Sorry, let me just check that. Let's go back. So that's minus 363. So we'll sum these two values to get the total enthalpy of hydration. So 3 and 2 is 5, 6 and 3 is 9, and 3 and 2 is 5, so that'll be minus 595 kilojoules per mole. Nearly count, that should of course be 685, minus 685. Okay, now we've got all the energy changes we need in order to work out this energy change. The enthalpy of solvation or enthalpy of solution of potassium chloride. And we can write this down, that the delta H of solution is going to be equal to some of these two energy changes. 715 and minus this figure over here, minus 685, and that gives us a total of 30 kilojoules per mole. So we have a slightly endothermic enthalpy of solution. Again, while chemicals like to lower their enthalpy, and here we see an increase in enthalpy, this will happen if the change is accompanied by an increase in entropy, which is the case here. In other words, a slight increase in entropy is compensated by an increase in entropy as the highly ordered lattice structure breaks down to form the less ordered arrangement in solution where we have these ion clusters. Here's a summary. And this question here, consider this for a moment, pause and consider your answer. Well, because the enthalpy of solution is positive, it means the process is endothermic and there should be a drop in the temperature when we add potassium chloride to water. Okay, thank you for listening.